Welcome to the T-minus 60 video series. In this video, we are covering a portion of the single event effects radiation types. A single event occurs when a single heavy ion or high-energy proton impacts a device. This ion will create a trail or electron pairs which can be swept up into the electronic field of the device. A heavy ion strike can cause many different types of effects. There are destructive effects, as listed here, as well as non-destructive effects. Another important point is typically heavy ions and high-energy protons cannot be mitigated by shielding of the device. We will cover the destructive effects in this video, and the non-destructive effects will be covered in a later video. The destructive single-event effects are single-event burnout, single-event gate rupture, and single-event dielectric rupture. Single-event burnout and single-event gate rupture are effects on power MOSFETs. These two mechanisms are sometimes very hard to distinguish from one another. What ends up happening is the gate oxide gets destroyed from the ion strike, and the susceptibility to burnout and gate rupture are voltage and current dependent. For commercial parts that exhibit burnout and gate rupture, it can be necessary to derate these devices for space missions. For example, a 100-volt MOSFET may have to be derated down to 40 volts due to these effects. TI space-grade parts have already been characterized for their higher ratings and thus do not need to be derated. On the graph on the right, we show the safe operating range for the TPS 50601-SB space-grade point-of-load regulator. The y-axis is the safe input voltage, and the x-axis is the maximum load. And the green area is the safe operating range of the part. Single-event dielectric rupture is very similar to single-event gate rupture, but it concerns non-transistor devices such as capacitors. Perhaps the radiation effect of most concern to designers is a single-event latchup. Most CMOS products are at risk, and this event can be destructive. Most CMOS products have parasitic PNPN structures in the middle of the circuit that can act like a silicon-controlled rectifier, or SCR. An ion strike at the middle of the part turns on this SCR, which won't turn off until the whole part is powered down. This SCR-like structure can draw more current than the circuit is designed to carry. This can cause the product to malfunction, and it will impact the life of the product, and it will eventually destroy the device. And in some cases, this can be less than 1 second. Some CMOS products are inherently immune because they don't have PNPN structures that could form an SCR. It is greatly dependent upon the design and/or the technology node, and it's hard to determine which product would be immune unless you have intimate knowledge of the design and the process. Single-event latchup is unlikely in standard bipolar products that are junction isolated. But TI still tests new products anyways to verify their SEL immunity levels. For a product that has SEL, mitigation is either redundancy or designing a circuit that will detect the SEL and then resetting the circuit once the SEL event is detected. To mitigate destructive single event effects, the only real approach is through redundancy. That can be triple voting redundancy within the IC, or via a primary-secondary approach for either a device or a whole subsystem of a board, or it can be done at the backplane or card level. Any of these options do, of course, increase complexity and increase weight of the overall system. For some of the devices that are designed for radiation from the start, they employ a triple redundancy approach within the IC itself to help mitigate these destructive single-event effects. Another approach sometimes used in power tree architectures is to set up a primary path and a parallel secondary path with a smart load switch to switch between the two channels when necessary. Another common approach is to work with a backplane that is designed inherently for redundancy. Many spacecraft use a combination of these approaches to try to reduce their exposure risk. For more information on how radiation can affect electronics, CTI's Radiation Handbook, and the link is provided here for you. Thank you for listening to this video on destructive single-event effects. Please watch the next video to learn about non-destructive single-event effects.